In this video, I'll show you how to download and install the free DeskProto CAM software. It's CAM software, so it's about computer-aided manufacturing, calculating tool paths for your CNC milling machine based on CAD data. DeskProto can handle all types of CAD data, either flat curves, where the cutter will follow the curves in the drawing, 3D geometries based in saved in STL files, and also you can use any image file where DeskProto will automatically create the 3D relief based on the image data. And best of all, DeskProto comes completely free of charge. Let's start the action now by opening your browser and visiting the DeskProto website. Here it is already, so enter. Here is the website, a menu structure, all products, all software versions, a gallery of interesting example projects, the download section that we will use when you want to buy a license. Note the manuals, tutorial videos, frequently asked questions, interesting links, the news sections, and the forum is also very interesting when you use DeskProto. But as said, we want to download the DeskProto software, so we visit the download page. As you can see, 9 different languages. Each link leads to a page in that particular language, but we want to use the English page, as that will allow us to download an English version of DeskProto. Okay, name and other data. Here we are. We are located in the Netherlands. Email address needs to be a correct email address, otherwise the email will never reach you, obviously. Newsletter, it's not sent very often, but it contains interesting information, so please check it. And this is the anti-robot question. The first word on the gray button, here's the button, so the first word is email. You have to enter that, otherwise the website won't accept your input. I can say email the download instructions, and it says okay, an email has been sent to info@deskproto.com. Okay, we go to our email system. It already came in. Here is the email, and here is a link to the final download page. Here we are, final step of the download process, and this is the actual link to the setup file, which is called dp70en for English.exe. Save it in some temp folder or something, which is okay. And when it is ready with downloading, we can start and run that file. The setup file has been completely downloaded now. And in Chrome, we can start it by simply clicking the file here in the bottom corner. For other browsers, you may need to open the file location where you downloaded the .exe file and start it there. So let's start it. Here we are. It gives a warning. A setup file made by Delft Spline Systems. We want to run it. And basically, it's a very simple process. Again, user account control. Yes. And here is the DeskProto setup program. It's a wizard. In fact, just a series of pages that you can run by pressing this next button a number of times. First page is the license agreement. As you can see, it's a very short one, just one page. You have to accept it, otherwise you can't continue to the next page. You can read the welcome text. On the next page, you see the location where the program will be installed. Just keeping it to default is best in most cases. Same for the name of the program to be used in the start menu. Next page, you can see set the icons. Normally, I leave it on default as well, a desktop icon for all users. short resume, and now the button is called install, as now the installation will start. As you can see, a large number of files need to be installed for this program. And finally, the finishing will also take some time until the finish button appears. Here it is. And we're all set. DeskProto has been installed. As you can see, the setup has added a shortcut to DeskProto version 7 to my desktop. I'll start by double-clicking. And the first dialog that we see is the initial settings dialog. DeskProto will show that only the first time you start DeskProto, you can select a machine, units, and a project type. Well, for the machine, a very long list of machines is present to choose from. Select your machine in case it is on the list. If it's not on the list, you can use the help button. The help page will tell you more. It's a good moment to show you the help file for each dialog. A wealth of information is present to assist you in using that dialog screen. So here, what to do when your machine is not listed. I'll keep it that way. I select ISO plain G codes, which is a good choice in many for many machines. As measurement units, I choose millimeters. We are in Europe. And a project type. DeskProto can handle three different types of CAD data. Vector curves, 3D curves, or 2D curves, I have to say. 3D geometry files and image files. Select the type of project, the type of CAD data you expect that you will use most. I'll, for now, select vector projects. You can always change that selection later. Okay. Then DeskProto is started. This dialog is called the Edition Select dialog. You are free to use the free edition as long as you like. No charge is required. The other three editions are paid editions, and they're available as well for evaluation. You can input your own geometry and send toolpaths to your own machine. Only the resulting parts will show a watermark, the trial cross, as its trial use. But the free edition doesn't have any such limitation. I'll start the free edition, and this screen is the start screen. You can select whether or not you want to see it each time you start DeskProto. You can either use the wizard, or you can use the dialog-based dialog-based user interface, and some resources for information. The samples folder, when I click that, automatically the folder with all sample files will be opened. Well, for novice users, the wizard is a good start. Here is the wizard, and next videos, different videos, will show you what to do for each of the wizards. This concludes downloading and installing DeskProto.